Right, so in this video, we'll look at another type of addressing scheme, which is called index addressing. So basically, we are using these different addressing schemes like indirect addressing and now index addressing to access different elements of the array. And if this array is large, for example, has 30 or 40 or 50 elements, then if we do not use indirect addressing or for that matter, direct addressing, or for example, index addressing, then we would have to use the direct addressing. And in order to do that, to access all the elements, you would have to write something like this. Move AX comma array 1, or rather array 2 plus array 2. This would access the first element. And similarly, to access the second and the third elements, you would have to write other statements like this. Right, so this statement will access the first element, the second element, and the third element. Since this array is of type word, we have to add multiples of 2 to the name array 2, because remember, the name of the array or variable is always pointing towards the first element. So this is array 2, array 2 plus 2, array 2 plus 4, and array 2 plus 6. So if we have a large array, we would have to write one such statement for each element, and that would not be feasible. Hence, we use either indirect addressing or index addressing. So in index addressing, what we do is, we place that multiple of 2 that we just saw inside the register. So for example, if we place it inside the EX register, now we can access all the elements of array 1 by writing move BX comma or array 2 plus EAX. And then if we write a loop for this, we can add something to EAX, and the next time it comes through, let's make this L1. So now if we have a loop over here, so the next time it comes to this instruction, EAX by that time has the value 2 inside it, and now it will access the second element, and then the third element, and then the fourth element, and so on. So let's say if we have moved the value of 20 element of 20 inside ECX, and let's say array 2 has 20 elements, then this means that just these three instructions will be able to access all the elements of array 2 one by one, because now the index is inside this register EAX. And you should always use a 32-bit register over here, otherwise that can result in errors, as we saw in the lab. So this is index addressing. Now there's another way of writing the same instruction, and that is if you use it like this. So array 2 and within brackets EAX. So remember, this instruction and this instruction are identical. There is no difference in these two instructions. They will both access the first element of array 2, or rather whatever is inside EAX. So if we have 0 inside EAX, both these instructions will access the first element of array 2, which means that array 2 plus EAX within brackets and array 2 and EAX within brackets is the same thing. They are both different syntaxes of using the index addressing. And you can use either one of them, but remember, whatever is inside EAX is basically an offset which is being added to the name of the array or variable over here. So in this way, you can also access different elements of the array, and this is called indexed addressing.